Hello friends, I am Dr. Mazhar Ali Dutio and I welcome you to my channel. Today I want to discuss the soft corruption with you, that what is soft corruption, how it destroys the institutions and societies, or what is the impact of soft corruption on the institutions and society. Corruption can be of any kind, but it impacts the prosperity and the development of institutions as well as destroys the societies, nations, and countries. The abuse of power in any sector is corruption. According to Wikipedia, the corruption is a form of dishonesty or criminal offense undertaken by a person or organization entrusted with the position of authority, or to acquire illicit benefit or abuse power for one's private gain. There may be different types of corruption, like hard corruption, soft corruption, political corruption, and etc. Whatever kind of corruption there is, it is corruption and it destroys the institutions, societies, nations, and countries. Hard corruption is often done by powerful people or competent authorities in organizations, because power make them powerful and give them authority to do anything in their organizations or institutions. But soft corruption is not about authority. It is about personal behavior. Therefore, it is a form of corruption that cannot be measured. The soft corruption is just as important and effective as hard corruption. Hard corruption causes great financial damage to institutions and societies, which stops the development of institutions and societies. Similarly, soft corruption is also doing great harm to society. Soft corruption destroys all institutions, whether political, social, academic, health, or administrative. Due to soft corruption, our institutions do not develop, which has a direct impact on the development of society and country. In fact, the healthy functioning of institutions promotes society or the country. If the institutions do their work on time, then the problems of people will be solved and the society will be developed automatically. But if they are slow and do not do their work or assignments on time, problems will never end. Soft corruption is caused by ignorance, intolerance, laziness, anger, jealousy, etc., which can be more effective and dangerous than hard corruption in various types of institutions. Soft corruption also occurs by those who consider themselves the most honest, consciousness, and social workers, and etc. There are many types of soft corruption that affect the development of institutions as well as other societies. Most of the people working in different organizations do not come to the office on time or leave the office prematurely, means before the time. For some reasons or another, means they will tell you some reasons of the late coming and going before, but they do not call this process wrong. This process does a lot of damage to the institution and the work as well, which affects the development of the institutions. Thus, this type of corruption is affecting the development of the nation and the country. Many people come to the office on the time and return from the office on the time as well, but they do not work in the office which work is assigned to them. They spend a lot of time in gossip, sit and drink tea, so it remains their part of the work, which also affects the development of the organizations and institutions, even the educational institutions. Many people do their job, but they are not interested in the work, which is why they cannot do any standard work. and thus there is no benefit for them except for the loss of time. Some people do this job to please the head of the organization, but they do not use their skills in this job and want to work quickly so that they have some time to talk to friends in the office or to use social media or to read the newspapers and etc. This behavior is also seen in many doctors, engineers, teachers, administrative staff, and professionals who are doing great harm to institutions where they are working. Some people take the recommended job, but they do not like that job, so they are not interested in their work, or do they work hard to their work, and because of this, their work is not standard. Many employees do not work in their offices because they work in employee unions in the organizations, which is why most of their work is left for another employee, and another employee has to do his or her work. Or sometimes their work remains. So such employees are satisfied that they are working for the welfare of the employees, but their behavior is detrimental effect on the development of the organizations because their work is remaining. Many political or religious individuals or social reformers who dedicate themselves to development of the nation and the country, but also have soft corruption that affects the society for which they want to work. These people want to improve society, but they do not like to meet the people living in the society. They do not like to listen to their problems and worries. They certainly talk about the development of these areas, but most of them only get personal benefits. Many elected public representatives who sit or sleep quietly in the assembly or the senate thus cannot talk on a wide range of topics or make any significant comments or play a clear role in improving a civic system. While the people have sent these people to the assembly so that they can work for the nation and the country, although many of these representatives are honest, they also commit soft corruption in this regard. This kind of corruption is doing a lot of damage to our society. Therefore, our society is not meeting the needs of globalization and digital society. There is a need for everyone to play their role in eradicating soft corruption in society. Soft corruption is the biggest obstacle to development. If soft corruption is eradicated, then hard corruption will be eradicated and our society will become a modern and a developed society. Corruption erodes the trust we have in the public sector to act in our best interest. It also wastes our taxes or rates that have been earmarked for important community. Community means the community projects, meaning we have to put up with the poor quality services or infrastructure, or we miss out altogether. So there may be different solutions to eradicate the soft corruption, but one is looking suitable, that is the power usage of technology. The organizations and government should implement the various types of information systems, database-based information systems, as per the requirement that all the employees may be bound to work assigned to them. Because of the implementation of information systems, no one can waste their time in gapshop, etc., because they have to finish their assignments. Moreover, all the tasks may be tracked and explained. If they are not working, their work will be shown to the management or the competent authority. Therefore, explanation may be called if work is not done on time by any employee. So technology is the best solution of this type of the corruption. If organizations are implementing the information systems and use the technology, they may eradicate this type of the corruption, means the soft corruption, and our institutions may be developed properly, and that development will lead to the development of society, nation, and country, and as well as the globe. So let's follow the new trends of technology and solve the departmental problems. Hope you like this talk on the soft corruption. If you like this talk, then please like this video and share it with your friends and different groups and organizations, that we may take some actions. Organizations may take some actions and install or implement the information systems and other technological tools. This talk, the theme of this talk is taken from the book Globalization and Sindhi Samaj, that is published by the PKAR Publishers, this book. And last, please subscribe to this channel and mark this bell icon that you may get the notifications automatically. Take care.